Nick and Morgan, today you will begin your life together as husband and wife. We are gathered here today to celebrate. In Genesis chapter 2 and verse 18, after God had created Adam, he said it's not good for the man to be alone. So he created woman and gave her to him to be his companion, his wife. Father, we pray that you'll help them to keep alive the commitments that they have made to each other this afternoon. And we pray that you will bring them blessings and success in their life. Father, that they would be able to spend a long life together, serving you, pleasing you, honoring you, and setting forth as a testimony, an example to the world of what true love is with one another. Father, may your peace and may your joy rest upon them from now on this their wedding day and for the rest of their lives together. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
1, 2, 3.
Someone has asked, what is really needed for a marriage to work and to last? 1 Corinthians 13 tells us that love is patient, love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist upon its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. So if you keep love in your commitment to each other, you will be successful. Nick and Morgan, having pledged your faith in and love to each other with vows, and having sealed your solemn marital vows with the giving and the receiving of rings, looking now unto heaven for divine blessing, and acting in the authority vested in me by the laws of the state of Tennessee, and under the authority of Almighty God as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now gladly pronounce you husband and wife in the presence of God and all of these assembled witnesses. Nick, you may now kiss your bride. And what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me very great pleasure and honor to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Nick Wyrosdick.